In this video, I'm going to show you how to pull data from another sheet based on a criteria in Google Sheets and Excel. It's pretty much going to be the same formula. We may need a little bit of extra thing in there to make it really useful in Excel, but overall, it's going to be the same thing. So let's say I have this worksheet and I want to grab only female from this column and basically filter the data on another sheet. So I'll basically just add another worksheet. I will call it data pool. And here what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna start with a filter function equals filter. I'm skipping the first row here because I'm gonna do headers there on top. So I'll do equals filter and then we'll go to our customers worksheet. We'll basically just highlight this data, not including the headers. Even though if you include headers, it's not gonna be the end of the world, comma. And then after the comma, we're gonna do the criteria. So I'm gonna select this column of genders. Again, you wanna make sure whatever range size you have here matches the range size over here. So from 2 to 12, from 2 to 12. So I wanna make sure that that equals to, now because these are text, we're gonna do female in quotes. If it was a number, you wouldn't use quotes, just type your number. So close parentheses, hit enter. And as you can see, we got our data just like that. I'm gonna just copy paste headers. So just like that. So the same formula should pretty much work in Excel. So if I just copy this, go to Excel, and just create another sheet and literally just paste it here. So as you can see, I got the same results. And then I can just copy paste headers and call it data pool. So there it is, that's our data. So now let's say we want to have some sort of drop down. So I'll go to Google Sheets first and do this here, and then I'll do it in Excel too, which is again gonna be pretty much the same thing. So let's say we want something like gender, and we want something that says male or female, and basically based on this value, we want this data to be filtered. So what I can do, I can go back to this first formula here on top, remove this quotes female, including the quotes, and after the equal sign, we'll just click on male, hit enter, and see, that's male. If I change this to female, that should give us female, and we can convert this to a dropdown, data validation. We can do list of items, and here we can do female, comma, male. Reject any other input, hit save. So now we should have this, see, dropdown where we can choose one or the other, and we get our list. And again, the same thing you could do in Excel. So let's just add some space here on top. Type gender. We'll type the gender here. We'll convert this to a dropdown. We'll go under data and do data validation. And here we're gonna do list. And as source, we'll just do female, comma, male. No spaces when you do these things, just a comma. You wanna make sure you type this correctly, not the way I just did. So now I should have this dropdown. So finally, let's connect that to this formula in here in this first cell. So we'll just go in here, remove this female in quotes and just link to the cell that says female, hit enter. And if I just filter this to male, you'll see it filters to male just like that. Now the problem here with Excel that you're gonna have with this function that you do here, if you pay attention right here, see for this middle initial for Jose, I got 0. Now let's go back to our data and take a look. See, we got middle initial, it's blank. Now in Google Sheets, we're not gonna have this problem. So if I go here and do Mail, see Jose, it's just blank, no problem. In Excel, it has a weird thing with blanks and zeros. So as you can see, it pulls the zero, which kind of sucks. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go back to this function and we're gonna change it a little bit. So what I'm gonna do, this first range that I did that goes from A2 through K12, I'm just gonna add an if function around this. So I'm gonna say if, open parentheses, that range, let's just do some spacing, that range equals to blank, comma, then return blank, comma. Otherwise, we're gonna just basically just return the same range. So I'm just gonna copy that range reference, paste it here, and close parentheses. So I'm gonna do this if wrapper around our main function, hit enter. And what you're gonna see now, the blank is actually returns blank. So this way, we don't have that weird thing happening with blanks. You could do a bunch of different conditions here. So if you wanted to do more than one condition, let's say in case of Google Sheets, you could just go here, add a comma, and then after the comma, you do another condition. So for example, let's say you wanted to filter by the zip codes. And I'm gonna think about these as a number, just to show you an example with a number sort of thing. But you know, the IDs, you could use any column to filter by. In this case, let's say as a second column, I wanna make sure the zip codes are above a certain number. So I'll just go in here and add a comma. And after the comma, we can go and highlight another range from our source data, our zip codes. Again, it needs to match the size as this one. And I'm gonna say it should be, let's say, greater than or equal to. You can do things like that instead of just equal to. So let's say we want anything that's above 9,000. So if I hit enter, well, I guess 9,000 wasn't a good idea because this is like 30,000. It should be 90,000. So let's actually change that to 90,000. This is why we should probably work with actual number data, not the zip codes, but there it is. We can see now we have a number. Now, the reason I did this, I wanted to show you, see, for a number type, we don't really do quotes around this number. I just typed 90,000. For text, I used to do those quotations. But if you do a cell reference, let's say just type like 90,000 here and refer to that cell, then it's really not gonna matter that much. So we can just remove this and link to that cell. And there it is. And you could change this to, let's say 60,000, and now we got those. So it works. So we have other types of comparisons here other than just equals to. And you can basically just keep doing commas and doing more conditions and doing other columns. Just remember that every condition you do is an and condition. So you're saying this and this must be true at the same time. And you could do the same thing in Excel the same way. And that should do it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.